Hello everyone. Thanks to everyone for watching this video. My name is Qi Dong. I am an architect and engineer. Today's video is titled Numerical Solutions of Ordinary Differential Equations, and it is going to introduce Rengakuta methods. I am going to give you an overview of what I am covering in today's video. First at all, it is a bit of background to the topic, and then focus on the Rengakuta methods and the numerical simulations before wrapping up with conclusions. In this video, we will use the abbreviation ODE referred to ordinary differential equations, a very unverbal definition. An ODE would be that it is an equation which contains one or more ordinary derivatives of the unknown function. Typically, the unknown function will be a function of one variable. Therefore, the derivatives are ordinary derivatives. Now let's just take a look at some ODEs. For example, x is my unknown, and it is a function of t. The ODE could be that the derivative of x with respect to t equals to x squared, or it can be second derivative x plus x times x prime, that is the first derivative, plus 4 equal to 0. We will be mainly considering the initial value problem for first order ODE in the following form. The derivative of your unknown is given as a function of time t and of your unknown. That is the differential equation. There is an initial condition given at initial time t0. X is given as x0, and this is called initial condition, and we will call it IC. Some simple example of an ODE with initial condition, say x prime equals to 2, and x0 equals to 0, which function its derivative is constant 2. So we know it is the graph of the function to be a straight line with slope 2, and by putting in the initial condition x0 equal to 0, we see that the only solution will be xt equals to 2t. Let's see another example, x prime of t equals to 2t and x0 equal to 0. You can integrate both sides, and you've got an arbitrary integration constant. It will be t squared plus a constant c. And then you put in the initial condition that c is 0, and your solution is t squared. Let's say another example, x prime equals to x plus 1, x0 equal to 0. The solution will be et minus 1. I want to say these are a few examples where the equations are simple that one has a way of constructing its solution. In a general situation, especially if f is a nonlinear function of x, finding exact solutions can be very difficult or impossible. We now will seek approximate solutions, meaning by some numerical method, and we find some approximations to the exact solution. The approximate solution will be constructed only at discrete sampling point, which we refer to as the grid. For most of the discussion, we will be using a uniform grid for the time variable. You choose a little time step and call it h, which is a small positive quantity. And then you just sample through time starting from t0. Every two neighboring time steps tk plus 1 minus tk equals to h. So every time you take the same step size, this gives a simple way of computing tk, which is just from t0 plus k times h. How many steps you take, and then until you reach the final time, which is tn, and n is the final time step. Given an ODE and the final computing time tn, what we do will be seeking discrete values xn, which shall approximate the exact solution at the grid point tn. The n goes through all the grid points, which will give us t from t0 all the way to tn. We now learn a type of methods called the Rank-Kutta method. We begin by observing that in the Taylor series method, especially in high-order Taylor series method, there is a difficulty in the method, that is, the method needs the high-order derivatives, like x double prime, x triple prime, which might be very difficult to get a better method. Should only use the value f, not its derivatives. So, this gives rise to a different type of methods, which we called Rank-Kutta methods. The first-order method would be the same as Euler's method. That is also the first-order Taylor series method, because we see that the method only uses f and not f prime. The second-order method is different. Fix some notations. Let h be the grid size. On time step size from tk to tk plus 1, given an xk, and we want to compute the next value xk plus 1 is computed as xk plus half times the sum of two constants. We call it capital K1 and capital K2. They are computed as follows. K1 is simply h times f evaluated tk and xk. So this would be the same term in Euler's method to be added on xk to approximate for xk plus 1. And then K2 is computed as h times f evaluated tk plus h and xk plus capital K1, which we have just computed earlier. Keeping in mind, K1 or xk plus K1 is an approximation to the value of xk plus 1, so this f here would be actually the x prime approximated value at tk plus 1. This is called Hinze method. Next, we take the fourth order method. The most celebrated one is the classical Rank-Kutta fourth order method. It takes a very elegant form. So xk plus 1 is updated as xk plus 1 over 6 and the sum of four constants, k1, k2, k3, k4, added up in this simple way with weights 1, 2, 2, 1. Here, k1 is computed as h times f evaluated tk and xk. Then k2 is computed as h times f at tk plus half h and xk plus half k1. This expression here is a good approximation of x prime at tk plus half h. And then k3 is computed as h times f evaluated at tk plus half h and xk plus half k2. That is just being computed. We see that this part of k3 here is a good approximation to x prime at tk plus half h. And finally, k4 is computed as h times f at tk plus h, xk plus k3, the most recent k. We see that this part here in k4, that is actually an approximation to x prime at tk plus h. So we see the method actually has very nice on coefficients and very elegant in the way. Now we will look at some numerical simulations for various Rank-Kutta methods. We will consider the same ordinary differential equation, which is x prime equals to negative x plus e to the negative t, where we know the exact solution, which is x times e to the negative t. The next plot we are showing here is the simulation using Euler's method and Hinze method. The exact solution is plotted as the black curve, and the Euler's method is plotted as the red circles at the grid point, and the Hinze method is the rectangles here. It is quite clear that Hinze method performs much better. We could also have plotted that the Rank-Kutta fourth order method on the same plot, but they would lie very close to the exact solution, and our eyes will not be able to see the difference. So here, instead of plotting the answer, we plot the errors which varies from Rank-Kutta method. The x-axis is t starting from 0 to 3 times step 0.1, and the y-axis is the error, and which is in logarithm scale because it is easy for us to see. We see on the red circles, that is the Euler's method, which is first order, we see the magnitude is about around 10 to a bit less 10 to the negative 4. And then Hinze method is here. These blue rectangles, and we know that is a second order. It should be of order h square, and we see that the error is 10 to the negative 2 square would be approximately 10 to the negative 4. We see it is pretty much on following our own expectation. The classical Runge-Kutta method is the fourth order. You would expect the error will be approximately 10 to the negative 7. You see the higher order method, in general, performed significantly better than the lower order ones. From conclusions, what we learned? An ordinary differential equation, ODE, is a differential equation containing one or more functions of one independent variable and the derivatives of those functions. In numerical analysis, the Runge-Kutta methods are a family of implicit and explicit iterative methods, which includes a well-known routine called the OLAS method, using temporal discretization for the approximate solutions of ODEs. Okay, thanks to everyone for watching my video today, and I do hope you found the video informative, and that you learned some things from it. If you do have any questions, then you can write comments and messages. I am happy to answer any questions. Thanks for your watching.